Good afternoon. I want to start with the personal. A few days ago, I buried my two aunts. They had died within 4 hours of each other. One was struck by a heart attack and hospitalized. A few days after, she was diagnosed as COVID-19 positive. She did not survive for long. Within a week of her arrival at hospital, she had died from the complications of the virus. My second aunt was a nurse. She also did not spend much time in hospital. They were both in the former Transkei area. The one hospital had no oxygen masks, no ventilators. It was overcrowded and nurses were severely overworked. Our story, of course, is not the only one. It is emblematic of the larger story. Thousands more are left devastated by the impact of the virus. At the funeral, which had started at 7 a.m., the priest told us that he had attended 8 other COVID-19 related funerals that morning alone. The former Transkei area was recently flagged as one of the poorest in the country. The virus has not merely highlighted the economic deprivation of the area, it has deepened it, confirming the structural violence that many poor South Africans are subjected to. I have no patience for COVID-19 denialism, but I also think it is a poverty disease. Older, poor people with comorbidities will likely die of COVID-19. People with access to good healthcare services will likely survive. It is time that we recognize this, both as a country and as a world. But we also have to recognize that race in South Africa looms large in the story. In this country, there is an undeniable link between race and class. This, of course, is a function of the past. We inherited an economy designed to maintain white economic privilege, an apartheid economy. That economy continues to define access to healthcare services. 26 years after the new democratic government has been in office, it continues to be haunted by the stubborn legacy of racialized inequality. But it is a challenge which it must confront now, not tomorrow. We as individuals must also do more. It is time that we develop compassion, solidarity, and ubuntu. Enjoy the lecture. Good luck.